Hello my friends, and welcome back to my channel. I'm working in my little journal, and you can join me if you would like to. I'm preparing some pages and making some small decorations today. It's a beautiful day with a lot of sun and warmth here in Sweden. So I'm going to do a kind of a shorter recording today so me and Nico can go outside and enjoy the sun. But we need to at least do a little something, I think. I try to have that as a goal, that I'm at least making something every day. So that me and my conscience is clean. I have a day off from my day work today. I had some time that I needed to get rid of, and compensation time that I needed to work off. So I thought I could do that today and enjoy the sun instead. So me and Nico is home today. I'm going to do this as a little talk spot. This little, they are from Tracy Fox. And I love these little cute babies. Perfect in my old looking journal. So let's see what we more could put in. I'm going to leave a few pages so I can use those as reading space or maybe decorate them later to personalize it a little bit more. In case the buyer needs to have some fun too. Not just get a journal that is all done. I hope I can part from this. It's a little bit difficult when you love every journal you do. But I'm trying. Bit of a really old book page. I like the layering. maybe we can put this on with a paper clip and use it as a writing space. So it's Friday here in Sweden, so we're looking forward to the weekend. I hope the weather continue to be warm and sunny so we can take our sketchbook and go outside and maybe do some painting this weekend. I love spring and I still haven't got any greenery or any flowers here in Sweden, but I like when the trees getting their first little touch of greenery. Let's put this embossed piece on the last part of the page. And then we can use this with a rusty paper clip and put that on the side. Maybe we could do something more fun. Let's take and put in a little eyelet. And make a little dangling decoration. What should we go for? That one. No. Have this coffee dyed small labels. Let's see if we can make a knot so we can put it onto the eyelet.
maybe with a bulb pin. If I have any of those.
It's in this one. I hope.
Should we go for the darker one? That one. So let's see if we have something to decorate this with. I think we should take the paper a little bit more easy to work with. A little bit of shimmer on it. So, let's see. That could work, but I want a background. Kind of, I think. Nice paper.
is an old prayer book from my stash. I love to have these originals to work with. Gives the book a special feeling. And then this on top of it. We are going to bend this several times. I think I maybe would want to put on something that will give it some strength. Should we use textile or cheesecloth? Maybe a thin textile instead. Or maybe both. I will leave it open in the top in case we want to use it as a pocket. For something small. There. Or I think I even have something thinner. Or maybe we should call it smaller. I'm looking for another blue one that I'm sure I have here somewhere. I saw it yesterday. But that was then. Come on, where are you? Nope, not today. Didn't want to be there. Maybe I have used it up already. Looks like that. Okay, let's go for this one instead. This is a copy of one of my snippet clusters that I have made. Don't forget you can use your things twice if you have made a beautiful pocket or something. Take a print of it and use it as a background for your other stuff. you can make a new snippet cluster out of it with putting items on it that are a bit more stiff. So this is a nice print of buttons and different labels and some gold. So perfect to use twice. I'm going to put a piece of background for it so it gets a little bit more sturdy. Let's see if I have some old book papers that I can use. There we go. That's a bit more sturdy. So this is from an old book from 1932. Sure that the glue is all the way to the edge. I think I will leave this old piece of text. Put that in as a little extra writing space behind that one. And our little dangle is right where we want it. Maybe we should put this way, so we have a flip out. So we can fold this like so. See if I could put something behind these two. That's it's not too big. Maybe another blue piece. So let's do the same with this one, so it gets a bit more sturdy and can be used as a talk spot. No writing space in the talk spot. I think I'm coming down with a cold. I'm kind of that feeling that I'm exhausted today. I hope I'm wrong. But I have this feeling that, you know, you can't think straight. And as you can hear, I'm saying something that I don't mean today. It's like my brain isn't working properly. But that is i för sig inte något ovanligt. That isn't something that is unusual. It's typical these days when you have a day off, if you kind of are relaxed and then it suddenly breaks out this feeling of getting down to the cold. But me and Nico is going to go outside and get some fresh air. It might be that is missing. Go down to the creek on the snowmobile tracks and see if we can get some new energy. Oh, I find a rusty one. That's nice. Or it's a bit dark, I think. See, I can't think. It takes a few seconds before my brain is doing what I want it to do. So should we put maybe a piece of lace on it? Or a ribbon of some sort? Maybe a piece of this one. This netting. See it? No, that was boring. We don't want boring, no. Scribble a text on it. Oh my. Maybe this one and some cheesecloth. Put it up in the corner so it won't get stuck when you put it into the pocket. using this in case I have a lot of glue that is outside the label. It will soak up with this. A little bit more of the scribbling. Personalize it a bit. Like that. So, what do we think? I think I'm going to leave this for now, so I can use it as a writing space if I would like to. She said, and changed her mind right away. Sorry. Let's continue with some embossed paper instead of wrapping it up. I saw a post on Facebook today. It was a lady that had found embossed wrapping paper. So I googled that and find a site where you can buy that. I haven't thought about that, but that was really nice, and you can kind of wrap bigger things and you don't need to have an embossing folder. So that was a good tip I want to give you too. If you would like to have embossed paper, see if you can find wrapping paper with embossed pattern in it. And you can use it like this in your books, even if you don't have any embossing machine yourself. I thought that was a really good idea to look for that. Better right away. Okay guys, I'm going to take Nico and go out in the sun. So have a nice Friday evening, and I will see you soon again. Until next time, bye bye from Sweden.